Dalmally, Scotland. A village you may have heard of, as it's dissected by the main road between Glasgow and Oban, but you probably never thought to stop. So what points of interest lie in this small picturesque village of approximately 500 inhabitants? Let's take a look around and see what gems we uncover. An interesting fact about Dalmally is the politician and former Labour leader John Smith was born in Dalmally in 1938. Dalmally is a small village in Argyll and Bute, Scotland, located along the Strath of Orchy, 2 miles east of the tip of Loch Awe. The name means pebbled valley, and the village probably started as a settlement serving nearby Kilchurn Castle, which was built in the mid-1400s. As you can see here, Dalmally is linked onto the railway network. We are now approaching Dalmally Railway Station. Dalmally Railway Station is on the Oban branch of the West Island Line and was originally part of the Callander and Oban Railway.
Hi.
The station opened on the 1st of April 1877. For a while it was the western extremity of the Callander and Oban Railway until the line finally reached its ultimate destination, Oban, on the 1st of July 1880. The station's red stone building and signal box are protected Category C listed buildings. The station was restored after 50 years of neglect into this rather quirky look you see today. The station now also houses accommodation comprising of 4 rooms and a shepherd's hut. After leaving Dalmally Railway Station, we shall now carry on down into the village. We haven't gone far when we happen upon an iconic British red telephone box. It looks like it's no longer in use. Though we do come across 3 hens just pottering around at the side of it. Now that's not something you see every day. It's late spring here in Dalmally, and as you can see, it's very green and pleasant. As you can probably hear, we have now hit the main Glasgow to Oban road that dissects Dalmally. Here we are passing Dalmally Fire Station. We're now approaching the Dalmally Hotel. It was built as a true haven surrounded by spectacular mountain scenery and set in 3 acres of beautifully landscaped gardens. The reviews seen tell another story. It closed in around July 2021. We have now crossed the road to see what's in the other half of Dalmally. We soon happen upon what looks like a church. Indeed, this is the Glenorchy Parish Church. The church is also known as Glenorchy Kirk and was historically known as the Church of Dissects. The rather unique octagonal church building dates back from the early 19th century. It is protected as a Category A listed building. The old churchyard, which surrounds the parish church, contains some ancient gravestones of the clan MacGregor, and Gallows Hill of Glenorchy is famed in Island tradition as a place of execution. The church is recorded in 1390 with mentions of Mountain Chief Ian MacGregor of Glenorchy, second chief of Clan MacGregor, who was reported to have been buried on the north side of the high altar in Dissects at the old church of Glenorchy. The present church was constructed in 1811. It was designed by James Elliot of Edinburgh. The octagonal church building is of Gothic design. It is finished with an eight-sided pyramidal slate roof and adjoined by a square Gothic tower. Just across from the church is the Glenorchy and Initial Community Orchard. The community orchard is run by volunteers and it's a hive of flora and fauna. The orchard sits on the banks of the River Orchy. Dalmally Bridge over the River Orchy was built in 1780 by Ludovic Picard, an architect who worked for Lord Breadalbane. Since 1780, Dalmally Bridge has been strengthened and repaired. It withstands the force of the river in spate and is a favourite spot from which to look for trout and salmon. In the orchard there are many spots to relax, here being a bench overlooking the River Orchy. When I visited, the bluebells were in bloom. Up these steps is Glenorchy War Memorial. It commemorates both the First and the Second World War. It was unveiled on the 11th of October 1924 and rededicated on the 6th of November 1949. Here we are stood on Dalmally Bridge looking towards the Crookham range of mountains. We are now back near Dalmally Railway Station and going to take a look up Monument Hill. It looks like there is a train in Dalmally Railway Station. We are now walking along the old military road that goes from Dalmally to Inverary. Here we get our first glimpse of the Duncan Ban Macintyre Monument. Duncan Ban Macintyre was one of Glenorchy's most famous sons and Gaelic bard. He was born in the now deserted township on the shores of Loch Awe in 1724. This extraordinary granite monument of 44 feet high was raised by public subscription in 1859 and dominates the Glenorchy and Loch Awe and its islands. Queen Victoria was thrilled by the view when she came to see it in 1875. Let's go see for ourselves what view thrilled Queen Victoria. If you enjoyed this video, you may also enjoy my video on St Conan's Kirk, another place 4 miles from Dalmally that is often bypassed. I will put the link up to that video now.